There were several times where, through pilot error, I'm afraid, yours truly messed up a couple of lines of Shakespeare.
Oh, no.
And yes, no, and the noise I could hear off camera was Judi Dench laughing.
Kenneth Branagh, it's lovely to speak to you about All Is True.
Thank you.
You're obviously no stranger to the work of Shakespeare, and I love how you get to play the man himself. Mm-hmm. Do you feel like you really know him now and what he was like as a person?
Well, it is funny to put on all of that prosthetic, that larger nose and the higher forehead and the beard, and then catch yourself in the mirror and see a reflection of what you've seen across my life and what the world has seen for 300 or 400 years, this famous image. And now, having worked in so many of the plays, going to the real Stratford to research this, a place that I'd worked before as well, there was an element of time travel, which was really a thrill. Sometimes when you play historical figures, you get a vicarious thrill of just sort of asking that question, which people do, about what it was really like. So once the candles went on and we were in rooms with just a candlelight and a couple of actors and these strong dramatic situations, it did feel as though we were getting a sort of sense of some part of the real Shakespeare.
Yeah, I mean, the transformation was absolutely amazing.
Thank you.
Are you drawn to mystery? I mean, there's so much mystery surrounding Shakespeare. You've obviously directed and starred in Murder on the Orient Express. Is that something you're drawn to?
I love sort of a detective story. I do love a mystery, actually. I always have. And around one of the things I think about Shakespeare that's so intriguing, maybe has kept him universal, is that we can't quite put our finger on him, can't quite hold him. We can't nail him down. We can't say exactly who he is. We have these elusive facts, which in this case do provide something of a detective story. Two sexual scandals with his daughters that are made public in Stratford, a contested will where he leaves the second best bed to his wife. Is that a good thing, a bad thing? We speculate on what that is. And then the unknown cause of death for a child, young Hamlet, who died when he was 11 in 1596, that we also investigate possible causes for. All of that, I think, gives a kind of tingle to the story that's more than just you know, visiting and revering great and famous people.
Yeah, it's really interesting.
Thank you.
And you're back with Judi Dench again. Mm-hmm. Are you basically like family now? I mean, she's your wife in this.
Well, we had played mother and son, and now we played husband and wife. And she, I think, is a great advert for you know, what a youthful approach to life is. She's timeless in terms of her spirit and her energy and her sort of attractivity. She's entirely and utterly vital. And yeah, there's now a level of trust which is very, very high when it comes to, for instance, in a film like this, arriving on set like we are now, having not rehearsed, but having discussed it maybe months before, but then actually saying, you know, we're going to see how it goes. We're going to see if a happening can occur. And you know that she's going to come out with her best game, same with Ian McKellen. And you know also that she's a generous actor. She's one of those people, you always have to tell her sort of where the camera is. She always has her back to the camera because she's never really worried about whether people see her face or not. I said, no, they paid, they want to see your face. So if you could turn around, you know, she said, but you're over here. I said, I know I'm over here, but the camera's over there. So do think of the audience.
You, Judi Dench and Serena McKellen, you're all kind of Shakespeare pros. Was there a Shakespeare off on set at all?
There was a lot of chat about Shakespeare. It was mainly me listening to those two who'd lived in Stratford and done seasons at Stratford playing the great roles, both terrifically interested in you know, the life of Shakespeare as well. So yeah, they're kind of effortless nerds about Shakespeare. They don't show off about it, but they just are incredibly knowledgeable. But the other thing I noticed about them is they're both incredibly interested in people. They're not inward looking. You know, one of the things I love about Shakespeare is that he's very observant about people, and I see them sort of gather the same information because they go out to people. So as actors, you see them picking up just because they're concentrated. They listen to people. That combination with Shakespeare of a genuine interest in human behavior and other people, and Shakespeare himself, makes for a dynamite combo in their work.
Did anyone show off the most?
I think, Judi Dench definitely showed off the most, because I think ultimately she probably knows a bit more than me and Ian. And there were several times where, through pilot error, I'm afraid, yours truly messed up a couple of lines of Shakespeare.
Oh, no.
And yes, no, and the noise I could hear off camera was Judi Dench laughing. This is a woman who used to come in on a Tuesday morning and say, how many? I'd say, what do you mean? Last night on University Challenge, how many questions did you get? I said, well, I didn't get any. She goes, yes, 3! And she was so highly, highly competitive, including in Shakespeare as well. But, you know, you're allowed to be that if, as she is, you are the best.
You tell almost like a white lie about one of your actors to protect your family. I was wondering, have you ever told a white lie before?
You do sometimes get wrapped up in, you know, what you might call the kind swerve away from the absolute unvarnished truth. And I can't think of a specific one, but I feel probably more than I should, but always with the right intentions.
Yeah, I do the same if I lie about friends cooking or something.
That's the one, yeah, you've got to do that.
Exactly.
The same when you go around after a show to see an actor, you can't say you must be so tired. You always have to thank them. Nobody gets up in the morning wanting to do something bad.
Lovely to speak to you, thank you so
Thanks,
much.
Thanks, Olivia, thank you.